AWS have a concept of the six advantages of cloud computing, and this is their way of articulating the benefits of cloud computing in comparison to traditional operating models. And it's a big subject for the exam. It's something that comes up in quite a few questions. So let's go through these six advantages. The first one is that you trade capital expense for variable expense. So remember, we talked before about how in the traditional model, you spend a lot of money buying equipment, paying for data centers. It's a capital expenditure, or CapEx. Whereas in the cloud, you're paying for your services in a pay-as-you-go model, and that's an operational expenditure, or OpEx. So rather than purchasing servers, you're just paying for what you use. Another advantage is that with CapEx, your expenses are tax deductible over a depreciation lifetime, and that can be several years depending on your country. Whereas with an OpEx model, your expenses are deductible in the same tax year. The second advantage is that you get to benefit from massive economies of scale. And this image here just shows some of AWS's thousands of customers. And you can see some of the biggest companies and the most well-known companies in the world just in this list. So because they have such a large customer base, they're able to aggregate their usage across those customers. It means they've got purchasing power to lower their costs, and they pass that on to the customers. So that means a lower variable cost for you. The third benefit is to stop guessing capacity. Now, if you've worked in IT, you know what I'm talking about here. In the beginning, when you're planning a new workload, you often have an idea of what you need in terms of the amount of processing power, storage space, and so on. And the reality is that often, once you've deployed your workload, you find out what you really need, and it's much less. So that means a lot of wasted resources. And I used to work as a consultant going into customers, and I'd see this in every single customer. There was always wasted resources. With the cloud, we just don't have this problem because we can actually adjust our capacity based on our demand. The next benefit is speed and agility. Speed is the ability to deploy resources easily and quickly, and you can do so through API calls, through the command line, or through the management console. And you can do so around the world as well. So you can not only deploy fast, but you can go global. Agility is the ability to react to change and bring things to market faster. So it means that in a competitive situation, you can respond to your customers' needs better than your competitor because you have agility. The next advantage is to stop spending money running and maintaining data centers. AWS want you to stop spending your money and also your time maintaining data centers, and instead put that time and that money into innovations. The way AWS see it is that spending time and money on data centers is low value. It doesn't differentiate your business. Whereas if you're a bit more intelligent and you put that time and that money into new innovations, bringing new services to market, then that's a way that you can differentiate your business and get a competitive edge. Lastly, it's go global in minutes. We've talked about this before. With AWS, you have the ability to deploy your resources all over the world. That used to be a very difficult thing to do, but now with cloud computing, it's actually very easy. And we'll see some examples of this later in the course. So those are the six advantages of cloud, and keep these in mind as you go through the course.